Today I'm going to show you how to conduct a jar test. We need only some very simple material, like a PET bottle marked up, and the syringe you can easily get in the pharmacy. That's basically all we need. The only thing what needs to be precise is actually the measurements, because we really want to mimic what's happened when we mix our chemicals in the tank. And I would suggest the easiest is to work on a per hectare base and divide everything by 100. So for example, you use 70 liters per hectare. In our jar test, we will be using 700 milliliter. 70 liters divided by 100. If you use a liter of glyphosate per hectare, we will be using 10 milliliter. Okay, so let's go through one. And I have three chemicals here. I have liquid ammonium sulfate, I have 2,4-D, and then I have glyphosate. So a very common standard scenario. So we start off with probably 400 milliliter of water in our bottle, because when you start mixing, you probably have only 60% of your water weight in the tank. And from 700 milliliter, just a bit more than the half is 400. So that's what mimics our tank. Ammonium sulfate is measured in per 100 liters rather than per hectare, but it's 2 liter per 100 liters, so per liter would be 20 milliliter, but because we're only working on 700 milliliter here, I have 14 milliliter of ammonium sulfate in here, which I put in because it's already pre-mixed. We don't have to worry about anything, ready to go. The next one is our 2,4-D, and we're working on a liter, so there are 10 milliliters in here. And agitation by hand, very easy to mimic. And last not least, we're putting our glyphosate in, again at a liter per hectare, so we're looking at 10 milliliter. So a little bit of a shake. In real life, we would be filling up our tank to 100%. That's what we're doing here as well. So basically the 700 milliliter I was talking about earlier, that's what we want to achieve now. And here is our full tank. And we have mimicked exactly what we would do in our mixing procedure. Now in this case, everything worked perfectly. Earlier on, I did this one here, this is exactly the same mixture, but I tried to cut corners and took less time. I used less water, and as a result, we have precipitate on the bottom and the mixture failed. So if you have clog up of your filters, the precipitate on the bottom there, that's actually what will do it. So simple as that.